Hello. It is time for more adventures of the super pandular variety. Thanks, Paul Schneider, for making this game 6 to 7 years ago. Oh, that's cool. You get a little mini screenshot of the area where you saved. I always like it when games do that. Daggerfall does that, as well as many other PC games. You don't see it quite as often in console games. What was I doing? Wait. I saved after I got that power orb. Didn't I? I think I did. Maybe there's another part of the quest that I didn't notice. I thought I had completed it, and I just couldn't upgrade anything because I needed two, but maybe I actually have to come back here first for some reason. Something about these blue apples looks mighty enticing. I feel like blue is a color of food that shouldn't look appetizing, because it's not found very often in nature as far as plants go, but for some reason it is super enticing. Like, I think the reason blueberries are blue, that's like an evolutionary advantage to ward off predators? I don't know, you don't really call it predation when you're talking about plants. You know, to ward off animals from eating them, because blue looks poisonous for some reason. But humans, we have it figured out. As much as I like this track, it seems super high energy for what's actually happening. Like, this is a pretty chill domain. Ow. Except for all the pinky demons. I can't wait until I get the chainsaw upgrade. Alright, I have the right key now. Wait. Yeah, I'm making my way back to the top of the mountain, which is where What's-His-Face was. Tyler, or Kyle, or Kyler. Tyler... Bring it to Tyler or Rondolph at the cherry... Right, yeah, Tyler told me to find Rondolph. The nerd robot has a lot of hit points. Should probably spend some of these skill points so my level isn't flashing down there. I'm sure playing this game on normal is not going to be possible to really bone myself too badly by putting points into the wrong things, so I'm gonna upgrade my damage some more. Ion to one point. Talk with Rondolph at the forge. Okay, where is the forge? Must be somewhere here, right? Crystal Cave, that's where I found the orb by circling around in a roundabout way. I just noticed that the shop has, I noticed the candy cane last time. I was like, what's the deal with that? Is this a Christmas game? I just noticed that there's also a Nintendo Entertainment System hanging from the other corner, which is fun. I guess by hanging onto one skill point, I'm still going to have to deal with the level flashing at me down there. Not that distracting. Okay, I can't go into this tent. Unless there's... Oh! Right. Okay. Very perceptive of me, as always. Oh, Randolph isn't a wizard. He's a dwarf. That's true. I don't have any armor. Hey, simple. Oh, it actually shows up on my character sprite. Nice. I had a feeling once I did the next step of this quest, it would give me another orb. Oh, I'll talk to Tyler again if I have to. Okay, so what do I want to upgrade here? It looks like it could also fit a cat. Yeah, I will go with sword. Oh, it's a knight sword now. Nice. This sword is actually kind of sharp. Good quality to have in a sword. It seems like I have a little more distance with it than I used to. I don't know. Hard to tell without a direct comparison. Yeah, it looks like I have a little bit more range on it. Tyler looks like he's in the wrong aspect ratio. I think someone squashed him from 16:10 to 4x3 or something. A fuzzball and a pink dress. I'll take it. Aww. Poor Fu. Ah. Oh, I wonder if this is a Tyler Durden reference. It looks a little Brad Pitt-esque. I can't believe I just waltzed out of here without noticing Randolph down there. Wonder if Randolph says anything different now that I've talked to Tyler. I like how he didn't actually forge anything. He just gave me the object and told me to use my pause menu. Alright, Blobby Forest. Okay, well maybe now that I have this quest in the Blobby Forest, I can find Meow there as well. I wonder if Meow will comment on my sharp outfit. Sword doesn't seem like it's doing that much more damage. Or maybe that was just a low roll. I don't mind backtracking in games like this as long as it feels good to play, which this game does. You gotta say, it feels a little... Oh, whoa. What is this? I'm scared. I'm gonna hide behind my shield. The backtracking doesn't feel as good when it's not like a big interconnected world. Like, it always feels cooler when, you know, everything's connected, like a quote-unquote proper Metroidvania, and you're sort of doing the backtracking yourself rather than the game kind of funneling you in that direction, if that makes sense. It's still good, but at least there's not a lot of backtracking I have to do. Like, it doesn't take me long to get through these levels. They're pretty small, at least. Oh! I thought that would be a friend. It wasn't a friend. I don't know why I thought that would be a friend. In hindsight. Oh, wonder what caused that level up to pop. Dang. Really brute forced my way through that one. Oh, I have something different here. Oh. Catch shuriken to create powerful crystals around you. Each point increases damage. Huh. Grants a chance to create a protective shield for 3 seconds after getting hit by an enemy. Not a fan of skills that require getting hit before they proc. Never been a fan of that. I mean, I'm still not using the shuriken that much. Like, I wonder how long they last and how many times they can stack. Well, let's at least take a look at it. So I figure if I have more points in that, I would be able to make more crystals appear. It's interesting because it's not like you have a limited number of shuriken. Like, you can kind of make this appear as often as you want. Hey! I got the grappling glove. I love reaching higher grounds. So I think you have to grapple on an actual corner. Like, it's not a generic wall grab. Which is fine. And that in the portrait there, it looks a lot like the Super Mario World key. So yeah, this crystal just kind of hangs out. It's interesting. It says it increases my damage? Each point increases damage. Oh, so maybe putting additional points into this doesn't make more of them appear. Oh, it looks like it's shrinking over time. Or maybe it just grew because I have 2 points in it now. Ow. So I wonder if the crystal itself... Oh, I see. Okay, well... That's kind of neat, but seeing how it actually works... I don't know. It doesn't seem like the kind of thing I'll use that much. I don't know. It seems okay. I mean, it only does 1 point of damage every time it hits. 1 to 3, it looks like. But maybe it'll be more worth it if I put more points into that. I mean, obviously it'll be more worth it, but will it be worth it enough? Is the question. That key looks scientific. I like that they bothered to draw portraits for the keys. Little touches like that, that make a game memorable. Nice. Okay, so you can press down to drop off of a ledge that you're hanging onto. Also, can I go this way? Oh, there's just a potion. Okay. Level 10 already. Time flies. More damage seems like an upgrade that will never let me down, so that's what I tend to go for when given the option. I guess the shuriken is potentially good because it can go through multiple enemies like that, which my magic missile cannot. It can only hit one enemy. So maybe I should have been putting points into the shuriken instead. Ow. Well, I have the blue key, and I'm pretty sure there's a blue door over here to the left. Hey, it's our friend. Or are they? Well, if you're such a hotshot ninja, why didn't you destroy the machine? If you know exactly where it is. Also, you didn't comment on my stylish shirt. Or, vestment. Queerus. Yep. Still no red key. Have I fought this type of robot yet? Wonder if they have names. Oh yeah, they do have names. I saw them in the credits. I don't remember what that one's called, though. I still have points. Yeah, I'll hold on to them until the rest of the skills unlock. Oh, neat. Wasn't sure if I could latch onto these little grabby blocks or not. Can I do like a wall jump off of it? Well, sort of. I can jump and then hold right, but there's no way to get like extra horizontality out of it, I don't think. Like, it's pretty much jump, but I can't hold right after I jump because I just hit my head. Oh well. Can I make this jump then? Oh yeah, I totally can. That didn't look like one I can make. Hey, there's a delicious pizza machine up there. Awesome. Oh no. The anonymous robot has a shotgun. No one should give Anonymous a shotgun. That is so irresponsible. Ow. Oh, right. I'm supposed to go back and talk to Tyler. Ow. Dang it. I thought this was the Blobby Forest. Not the Hundreds of Robots Forest. They should change its name. This guy has a shield too. Also, it dispenses bullets from its midsection. Okay, so that'll probably let me circle. Okay, so this will draw me down to that library area, so go up here first. I mean, these things don't look like robots. But they're still wearing masks, so I guess they're in league with the robots. Pretty sure the title screen had a UFO on it, which indicates that there's going to be some sort of aliens in this game at some point. Ooh, glittery key. And aliens are often green, so that is my current theory. Probably take the high road back to destroy that machine. Probably faster that way. Oh, it makes an actual little finger gun when he shoots the bullet. That's fun. That's not just flavor text. That's an actual thing. I think when I got the mind bullet, the description said you shoot it from your finger, and you actually do. Cowboy Robot makes me think of SteamWorld Dig. An excellent game. Do I just smack it? Yeah, I guess I do. Currently being Let's Played by Deceased Crab, so check that out if you were unaware. Keep forgetting to use my crystal. Honestly, like, it doesn't really matter how effective it is. Having something circling around me like that in a game, I find kind of distracting and not really enjoyable. So I probably wouldn't use it even if it was super effective. I feel like I just, like, my mind bullet was a lot bigger for that one shot for some reason. Might be seeing things. Was wondering if maybe, like, having the crystal doesn't increase my sword damage or anything, does it? Or my projectile damage? The machine is destroyed. Mr. Alfonso, I'm glad he's okay. I don't even know who he is. And Meow has poofed away. Aw, man, I totally could have gotten that moon. Ah, well, I have to go back for it now. Shouldn't take too long. Getting occasional jitteriness with this game. And I don't know if it's the game or if it's my recording setup. I am recording at 1080p60, which is a lot of compute, but I was recording Doom at that resolution and frame rate as well, and I didn't notice any jitter with that. Of course, Doom is a much older game, and even though it's a modernized version of the engine, I'm sure rendering that stuff isn't as hard as like a modern, you know, game engine. Although this isn't this doesn't seem to be made with Unity or anything. It's a pretty small download, and it seems like a custom engine, and it runs really well. It doesn't use a whole lot of RAM or anything. Okay, I guess I can't get the moon? I guess I already pressed that switch? Or it was already pressed? Huh. H drink? What does the H stand for? Huge? Is it a huge drink? You know, the generic version of a big gulp. The huge drink. Oh, it must stand for hemoglobin. Because it's red. Like blood. And it's restoring my health. I'm probably losing a little bit of hemoglobin every time I get hit. And that drink gives me additional hemoglobin. That must be what it is. No exit on this side. All of the sound effects in this game are so good. Like, even if they weren't necessarily created for this game, you know, if they're from other sources. The selection of sound effects, you know, there's still an art to that. Choosing sound effects that sound good for the situation or sound good for the kind of game it is. Oh, Mr. Alfonso is that mouse. I talked to him. Alright, still gotta find the glowworm, which I can probably do now that I have the claw. Cherry Mountain Camp. No, I have two orbs. I don't want to wait and upgrade my sword again. I'm all about the violence recently. I've been playing Doom and Contra. Just massive amounts of dude murdering. Now I just want to upgrade my damage, upgrade my weapons constantly. I haven't felt violent. Must be some sort of subconscious urge I'm releasing through the video gaming. Which, I guess, as far as ways to release your violent tendencies go, video games, you know, you could do a lot worse. You know, I prefer unleashing my violent tendencies on demons and robots and Nazis rather than people, so I mean, I was fighting a few people in Contra, but, you know, they were probably aliens in disguise now that I think about it. There was a giant mechanical blobby that disturbed the peace. How do you know that? Oh, okay, Mega Man reference. I get it. Sure. Wait. Oh. Oh, okay. The glowing on top of the mountain. Is that just the glowworm? Like, is that the mountain with the tower? The wizard's tower on it? That I have to go to defeat, or defeat, to find the glowworm? Because, oh. Right, it's the other cave passage that has... What's his face? Dumbledore. Dumbledwarf. Okay. No new dialogue. When I set up the controls, one of the buttons it gave me was a back button that sounded like it was a button I could press to, like, back out of a level or exit out of a level, but it doesn't seem to do anything. Very strange. I'm not sure if it would actually take me to the world map if it did work. It must be circumstantial. Vanilla Rock. Do I have a quest there? Oh, right. That's where I'm supposed to look for the robots. Murillo Mountain. Oh, maybe the glowy mountain thing isn't the glowworm. Hey. Oh, Meow is a she. I didn't know that. I apologize if I referred to her otherwise. You can't have that. Mr. Alfonso can't teleport. He's not a powerful wizard. Unlike most of the other characters in this game. Okay. Yeah, I'll continue with these two quests. I think I can continue with the glowworm quest now that I have the grabby claw. Does it not work underwater? I guess they don't work underwater unless you have power. And I don't have power. I mean, I do, but not that kind of power. Also, this ledge is just high enough for me not to be able to grab it. Oh, that's a bummer. So the thing in the skull mask isn't a robot and it's not green. So I don't know what the other enemies are. Just generic forest critters, I guess. I bet the perk that gives you a chance of not taking shield damage would be a good one to have. That's a defensive perk I can get behind. Oh, okay. When I got hit, I didn't notice before that your shield kind of makes a pulse effect when it gets hit. I saw the pulse and I thought maybe there was some sort of timing element to the block. That'd be kind of neat, like if you blocked just before you get hit, you take less shield damage or something. Like a perfect block kind of thing. Which might be a thing later on. But if it's not, that's okay. Well, this area seems bad. I guess I just have to jump it. Okay, that wasn't as bad as I thought it would be. Although, I can't progress because I don't have the yellow key yet. Oh wait, no, I can progress. Okay. So this is probably the direction to get the yellow key, and then I can leave through that door instead of going through all the spikes. Yeah, I'm glad I put all those points into stun. I think it's helping more than is apparent. Oh yeah, I saw another one of those somewhere. The magic crystal I need some sort of object to interact with. Don't know what the deal with that is. I don't know why I just stood there. I was thinking, should I attack or should I back up and use some sort of projectile? And obviously, I should have attacked. Oh, okay. That experience, it took a second for it to pop up. That's why it seemed to happen for no reason. Okay, yeah, I'll continue hanging on to the points until I see what my other options are. I can ignore the blinking level icon. Haha. My projectiles can go through terrain. Is this thing healing? I don't know. It feels like the nerd robot got some health back at some point. Yay! Much like any good Metroidvania game or Zelda game, every time you get a key, it has to let you know that keys open doors. That's okay. At least it's not a very intrusive information box and you don't find keys that often. Man, that thing just owned me. Just having a little look around here for anything I might have missed. Missed this stuff. I don't know how I get up there. and probably have to come at it from the other side. Oh, I'm out of shield juice. I was like, where's my shield? Why is it not working? Who would have thought shield juice is an actual resource that I'm going to have to pay attention to and manage? I thought that was just a formality. That thing really hurt me. I'm gonna die if I take another hit like that. Which is why I'd like to get to the save crystal. Well, it's important to show off what the game over screen looks like in a game like this. Okay, so obviously I saved at the same crystal. But this was before I got the yellow key, so I'm going to have to redo a little bit of stuff here. But it's okay. For the purposes of showing off all of the game screens and mechanics, you know, I have to show how the death mechanic works. For the purposes of informational coverage. Should probably try to stop getting hit quite so much. I mean, getting hit a little bit is okay, but everything in moderation, you know. Ow. You would think the 5-second animation it takes before that thing actually shoots would serve as some kind of early warning system that it's about to hit me, but you would be surprised. Telegraphy? What's that? I guess my level and stuff didn't save upon, you know, loading my save, which there's no reason why it would. Unless the game was specifically designed like that. Which might be necessary in a more difficult game, but this game is pretty chill so far. Feels fair. Feels, you know, not too much of a challenge. I wonder if I have to interact with that red gem when I have the red key to make those blocks disappear. But if that's the case, then the yellow one would just look like a normal save crystal. So there's probably another object I need. Utilize some of my shield juice now that I have it again. Shield juice doesn't regenerate, I guess. Is there a perk that makes it regenerate? No, maximum capacity. There's that one, which I'm thinking about. Actually, I think I might, yeah, I'll put my remaining points into block mastery. So I guess you only refill your shield meter by picking up shields. So with 3 points in shield mastery, I wonder what my chance is of not using shield juice. No fair. This thing has a sword and a gun. I don't have that. I mean, I have that, but that's not a gun. Okay. I just wanted to grab that XP. Oh, this thing can shoot through walls. Hey, nice. My ability proc'd. It just said block instead of having a number, which means I didn't lose any shield juice for that one. Hey, a door. I mean, the other kind of door. Whoa. Took me to the other side. Hey, safe. Nice. Mana leaf sounds like a euphemism for something. Something that the wizard might enjoy. Is something actually happening when I touch those hats? Because I feel like it makes a sound effect after I kill the cowboy robots when their hats fly off. I want to say it makes a sound effect when I touch the hat and the hat light disappears with sparklies, but I don't think that actually does anything. I don't know, maybe it's worth bonus XP or something. Wombo comboed that jerk. The glowworm has functionality. Ah, nice. I like it. Of course, once I give the glowworm back to Quentin, I won't have this ability anymore. Which makes me think, you know, hopefully Quentin will be a pal and let me borrow the worm or give me some other similar item. An item of equivalent functionality. Thought I was gonna shoot. There we go. I was expecting to pop out on the other side at some point so I could get that power orb. I probably have to drop down from up above somewhere. Maybe after I get the red key. No thanks. Strawberry tea, that sounded okay. Not sure about unicorn dust. Oh, of course. Wizards. You can't fathom them. Would you kindly move out of my way? The angry birds are like nothing. I didn't stun that demon too well. I wonder if the stun is an effect that has a random chance of proccing or something. No, it just says increases the duration when I level that up. Maybe you can't stun the demons when they're charging. I bet that's it. No, I can. I guess it's just not always effective. Oh no. Oh, I ran out of shield juice. Crud. Oh, that Rocky Wrench type character does quite a bit of damage. It's not throwing wrenches at me. It's throwing radioactive acid fireballs at me. The free block is, it's also pretty nice because you have quite a few iframes after you get hit, so gives you a lot of flexibility there, potentially. I think I'm going to put some more points into that. Gotta remember to keep an eye on my shield juice, not just assume that I have it, now that I'm using the block more frequently. It's an interesting mechanic. Not quite like anything I've seen in a game before. So I wonder what happens if, for example, I have 2 points of shield left, and an enemy hits me for, like, 10 or whatever. Like, do I take 10 points of health damage, or does that just break my shield? I imagine I need the red key before I can do anything else here. I thought I hit the shuriken button just for a change of pace. Oh. Can't come this way. Oh, I see. Aw, man, there's like a helmet up there. And I don't know how to get to it. Can't break that block with my head. Yeah, this is definitely a solid stone. Oh well, at least I figured out how to get that XP. I'll just have to come back for the helmet. Once I have something. God, that did half my health. Holy crap. Okay. The foes, oh boy, are starting to get a bit nasty. Like, even if I did have the red key, I'm not sure how I would go about getting outside of this ziggurat structure. Okay, I'm just going to go for that experience star and then get out as quickly as possible. Because stuff here is dangerous. Need to remember I can move with the shield out as well. It's not something I've been using a lot, but that would be useful in some situations. Like when there's an enemy blocking my way that I have to drop down onto. Having my shield up when I drop when I fall on it would be pretty useful. Oh, I bet pressing that button down there gets rid of these blocks, and that's how I get outside the ziggurat. Ow, Jesus. Wasn't having any trouble with these spikes the first time through. Alright, so press that. Nope, didn't time it right. Oh well, I mean, it's not like it's a lot of experience points. And I'm going to be back here at some point anyway. Maybe I should start thinking about the shield capacity upgrade if I'm going to be using my shield a lot more. Okay, I'm not going back for the experience points this time. I'm just gonna pop out this way. I mean, I'll get those experience points eventually. Probably need the double jump to get that moon, or whatever. The jumping upgrade is jetpack or whatever it's going to be. Doesn't seem like the type of game to have invisible blocks that I need to jump onto. Sploosh. Okay, going back to the village. Wait. Oh, right, I have to help his family. He lives under the Eternal Tree, but I need to help his family before whatever the next event is in this quest. Oh, Quentin lives under the Eternal Tree. Okay. Coming up on an hour here. I think that's good for this episode. This is a good stopping point. Thanks everyone for watching. I'm still having fun with this game. Starting to get a little more challenging. Not, you know, I'm not frustrated or anything. Had to repeat a couple segments there. I mean, I didn't have to. I was going back for experience points that weren't strictly necessary at that point. But I'm having fun with this, and I will definitely continue this. Tune in tomorrow for more Super Panda Adventures. Bye.